mess in here, baby.
Hey guys, how are you doing? Welcome to May the 4th celebration stream. It's gonna be a special day, everybody. I love Star Wars, as you well know, and as you can see right here, here behind me. Ooh, there he goes. Woo, this little buddy here, and yeah, I even got this little baby. So I love Star Wars, and today As I just told a friend of mine who shares Star Wars love on Discord, I used to not really understand this day, but it grew on me. It grew on me as a Star Wars fan, and today we're going to celebrate it. So we got Yoda, Baby Yoda with us here. We got a whole bunch of nerd stuff behind me. We got, you know, we're going to have just a bunch of topics about Star Wars and, of course, some Star Wars vintage gaming. Today, this is my desktop screen. GLaDOS is the PC, so, you know, that's the screen. And today we're going to be scoping my Steam list and scoping it for Star Wars specifically. We are going to take a look at some old games. I had my eye on this as a starter. This is a game from 97 called Jedi Knight Dark Forces 2. This was one of my best memories are from this game. It had the really weird multiplayer. I barely remember it, but it was the first game I ever modded. In my life, it had a bunch of mods for it. I just noticed my microphone is extremely far away from me. So we're going to try it. I haven't even opened a bunch of these games. We're going to play a bunch of them, and then we're going to reach Battlefront 2 eventually. Yeah, let's just go with it, right? Let's just go with it and see what happens. This might be very loud. I'm warning you. I'll try to control the volume if I can. Ooh, the screen went really weird. Well, because it's really low resolution. Hold on. There you go. Yeah, this is not gonna be like resolutions that you are used to. Ooh! There we go. That's how you open a Star Wars stream, right? Yes. Dark Forces 2, Jedi Knight. Alright, since the destruction of the second Death Star, the Rebel Alliance has begun the difficult process of building the New Republic. Oh, so this is after, okay. Seizing the opportunity for control of the galaxy, new rival armies arise. The most dangerous of these are the Dark Jedi. Their leader, Jarek. Right, I'm starting to remember this. Seeks the legendary Valley of the Jedi. Within the lost battlegrounds, he will untold destroy peace within the galaxy. Yay! Alright. Cool. Hold on, sorry. Every time I tab out, this is gonna stop. There you go. Alright. Yay! Oh, Drew's here. Hey, Drew, man. How you doing? Not a Star Wars fan. Look at these graphics. Look at these graphics. Oh no! What happened to the Corvette? This is a familiar scene of some sort. Has the Corvette like spinning in place? We got a Super Star Destroyer. Oh jeez. I guess they did it as like a nudge, like there's a destroyed one already. Oh, it's actual, okay, it's actual actors. I didn't remember this. This is gonna be funny, guys. Oh, this is the Inquisitors. All right. Oh my God, this is so classic, guys.
I hesitate. Strike me down.
In time, Ron.
Guys, this is the original. Head Inquisitor. Before we had the new Rebel stuff. This is the original guy.
Morgan Catan!
Morgan Catan.
This dead man holds the valley's location. Mm. Very intriguing. I have no further use for you, old man.
This is basically like fan film quality these days. Even lesser than that, but it's funny. This was, look at that! Oh, he uses the fucking thing as a... Pop! Oh, jeez, the sound. Hold on, let me lower the sound of this a bit. This is going to be something, isn't it? All right, we're going to lower the sounds just a tiny bit. Okay, this is a bit better. Name. Oyster. Difficulty. Let's go for hard. I don't know why. Maybe it's going to be horrible. Okay. Ooh, we actually have a menu. Into these clicks. Okay, let's do some single player. The fact that it had multiplayer was the thing, right? And that's what I played a lot. Like, a lot. With a lot of mods and shit. The double lightsabers. Doing a lot of lightsaber fights. The mechanics, as far as I at least remember them and fantasize about them, these were great mechanics that I didn't experience in many games. Alright. Full subtitles, yes. Rotational map. I don't know what that even means. Sure. Oh, these menus. lightsaber auto camera. Yeah, sure. Let's enable. I'm not sure if this is the one we want, but we'll see. Ooh, look at these options. This is our resolution right now, guys. Oh, what video options? Enable 3D acceleration. Ooh, we can get up to, ooh, let's try it. Let's try it. Okay. Well, I already lowered the volume outside of it. Cool. Look at this. Oyster, we should do Jedi Academy multiplayer arena goof around session. Maybe. Maybe we'll do that. That could be good. All right. Oh god, this menus, it's so nostalgic for me. Alright, we have another cutscene. Nar Shaddaa. By the way, I'm not gonna do like a full playthrough of this. Just you know, keep that in mind. I'm just kinda scoping through it, right? We're gonna play other games as well. But just getting into it, it's so atmospheric, I love it. Look at this low res. Flying through the city. Nar Shaddaa.
Ooh. I want you to remember, son, when you're at the academy, how very proud I am of you. What a fine young man you've become. I wish your mother were here to see it. But I know she watches over you and is proud. After she died, your welfare and upbringing were the only thing I truly cared about.
Touching. When someone desires information, they come to me.
Don't waste my time, 88. Tell me who killed my father.
Patience. He is a dark Jedi.
Jedi?
Dark Jedi. He is known as Jerrick. And he has great plans for the rebirth of the Empire.
I'm not interested in petty political struggles.
Well, you should be. Without going into too much detail, Jerrick has been quite generous in his offerings. Unfortunately, you don't factor into them.
Oh.
But I am not without a heart. Familiar, yes? I found it in your dead father's home. I can decipher any language or code known, but this one eludes me. It must be important. Tell me what it is, and these gentlemen won't have to indulge their darker side.
The dark side? I've been there. Do your worst.
He's been there.
Well, I suppose that concludes our business.
I'm not interested in leaving. I have some business to conclude with your friend, 88.
Kyle Katarn, everybody. Oh, man. Oh, hello? What's going on? I can't see shit. Oh my god, the screen is all black. Okay. Come on. Ah! Okay, I think we screwed up the graphical options. Hold on. Setup. I think we fucked it up. Let's just leave it on this one. Without the acceleration. There you go. Oh, there we go. I can see something on stream. I can't see myself. Okay. Okay, apparently we killed him. Hold on. What the hell is going on? Give me a second. So we need to fit this to screen. There we go. Now let's try it again. Ooh, okay. It keeps jumping. Every time I go in the menu, it changes the resolution. This is so horrible. Why does it do that? Okay. That's really weird. Okay, well, first thing first, I need to reverse direction of the mouse, please. Please do. Okay, I'm not sure what we'll do with this. We'll just not come back to the menu anymore. But let me try and at least get it to the right size. Yeah, you see, I'm alt-tabbing and it goes away. Let's stretch it up a bit. I'm not sure how much I should stretch it, but we'll try. Just to make it slightly bigger for you guys. This is already going great, isn't it? Oh, geez, look at this. Okay. Oh, God, this is so weird to control. No. I did inverse. It still feels weird. Maybe I need to cancel that. Ah! Sorry, guys. This is... Old gaming is weird. Old gaming is weird. Also, the sensitivity is going crazy. Just the lowest you can be, please. Alright, let's try this now. Okay, it's bearable. It's kind of bearable. The up and down is inverted. I don't know why. Don't ask
me. Hey.
Hey.
What's happening?
Look at this guy.
I know nothing.
Okay. Wow, it's really weird. The mouse is inversed, but only for up and down. It's really weird. And very hard to control. Ah! This is so loud. Oh, shit. Guys, this is extremely weird. I don't know what I'm doing. What was the other weapon? How did I get... Oh, there he goes. Okay. Oof. Hello?
Get out of my barn. You always cause trouble.
Screw you! Alright, sorry it's kind of on a half a screen, guys. Ooh. Mysterious. Wait, let's try... The ambush attempt. As per usual. Classic sounds. Ooh. A shield. This is very loud, isn't it? This is, doesn't bode well, these, Okay, guys. We gotta fix this graphics. First of all, let's reduce the game volume even more. I'm pretty sure I reduced it lower than that, and it just went up on its own. Second thing is, let's try and do something about this resolution. Because the menu goes like at this size, and then the actual game goes on a different size. Now, which size is this? It says... Okay. That's weird, though. That's really weird. Oh, okay, let's... I'm trying to calculate it. It's like... 600 and something? 640 by 480, is it? Really? Like, if I return the game now, does it stay the same? Yeah, kinda, okay. So I need to stretch it up way much. The other is not so bad on stream, maybe I'm hearing it really loud. How big can I make this screen? No, I can't. I can make it fit. Let's just try. Do some attempts here. I don't know why at like the beginning of the game I could alt tab and do everything, and now for some reason I can't. Okay, this is a slightly better. We need just a tiny bit more, and center it up just a bit, right? So let's do this and put it here. This is gonna be strange as holy hell. Oh, no, too much to the side. Ah! The game is spawning other minions at me. Hold on. We almost got it. We almost got it. There we go. Like this, maybe? Yeah, okay, we kinda got it. There we go. Ooh, okay, I got a map, apparently. I'm not sure how I opened it up. Okay, tab, there we go. Ooh. Well, he died quickly. Ah! We just... Wait, what's going on? Why don't I have any ammo? Ah! I died! Oh, no. Okay, cool. So this guy escaped us first, right? So we need to pay attention to our shots. Okay, we'll do this. The right click is jumping, apparently. Can I inverse the up and down of this mouse? Seriously, this is the worst. The up and down thing. Y axis, pitch up down. But it's inversed. Reverse direction. Yeah. I don't know how to make it work. Okay. A fire 2, button 3. Okay, that's interesting. Yeah, sure. There's no joystick. Always run. Sure. What do we got here? Yeah, nothing really. Okay, well, we'll have to deal with it, I guess. Old gaming. Jeez, the up and down is really getting through to me. It's really hard to aim like this. Shut up. Wait, how do I jump again? There we go. Ooh, energy cells. Alright, you gotta explore. There we go. I remember these stashes. And you can click on this, I believe. If I'm not mistaken, I don't remember the button. Oh. Never mind. Go. You can go up there, as far as I remember. Here we go. Okay, much better management of my, Oh! Well, I'm wounded. That will probably help just a bit. Can jump pretty high. How do I, Oh, okay. That's it. So maybe I could have opened some other stuff. Well.
What's happening?
Okay. The strafing was learned these days. Jeez, this is something. No, Greedo, no! Okay. Well, this is something, isn't it? This game probably doesn't have a functioning multiplayer.
Get out of my barn, you always cause trouble.
No, I don't. That's not true at all.
I know nothing.
Wait, so can you open this? Where is he talking from? He's on the other side of the wall. Okay, cool. I'm getting into it. I don't think the difficulty level is helping us here. Levels. Oh, oops. It was just a guy. Sorry, dude. Ah! There he is. Okay. Ooh, shiny. The music is kind of the best thing about these games, really. Guys, just in general, if you have any Star Wars questions, Star Wars topic you want to bring up, you know, something you want me to talk about, please do. This is Star Wars Day, so we can talk about everything Star Wars and nerd out. And if you don't know enough about Star Wars, don't feel bad. Just go watch some of the movies. Not the new ones, necessarily, but some of the movies. Oh! How dare you. Am I out of ammo? That's not good. I was slightly too callous with my shots. That's not good at all. Okay, let's see what goes on in here. Ah! Yeah, this is not good. Not good at all. I only have punches. Come here, boys. Come here. Ah! Shit! No, my ass! My precious ass! No! His hitting doesn't do any damage. Well, difficulty is difficult. I can say that. Poor Kyle. Let's see if this game has any multiplayer left. Pretty sure it doesn't, right? Pretty sure it doesn't. Oh, this is something, okay, right? This is something I messed with a lot. So you got different ranks that you can maybe take. So let's do like, I don't know, let's do a Jedi Master, right? Oh, look at this. Okay, so we got a couple of models here. Oh, this brings back so many memories. And you could download some stuff for it as well. So we got some new models and some new lightsabers and some stuff. Admiral, yeah. Ooh, Mandalorian. Yeah. Santiago. Everybody looks the same, pretty much. The same model. Oh, there we go. Saris. Jan Ors, of course. Very familiar. Commando. And we got all the Imperials. Oh, check this out. And his hand is still without a glove. Yeah. Trandoshan. Tusken Raider. Cyborgs. So you got C-3PO running around. Oh, people were using all of these. That was kind of fun. Jarek. Green. These are just Kyle Katarn in weird uniform. And that's it. Yeah, that's what you had. And you could change your lightsaber's color, obviously, which was like the most important thing. Force powers that you choose, right? Aw, this was great. You did that to people. This was like the best epic, you know, fighting days with like Star Wars PvP, right? That was something. Oh, jeez. Okay. Let's, can we join something? Look at this. Sure. I need to join something specific, right? Yeah, there you go. See this? This is how old multiplayer worked, guys. You needed to find servers, right? And you had these, this shit for your local. Oh, God. Host game, right? Let's just host a game. Ooh. Here we go. Oyster game. Max player per group. 32. Do we have bots? I'm not sure we have bots in here. Let's do Jedi Master. Capture the flag. The duel. The duel, sure. Oh, I had advanced over there. Hold on. What is advanced? Oh, don't care about that. Yeah, sure, let's take this one. Oh, look at this. Yeah, sure. Microsoft Corporation. Oh, there we go. Alright, but this is... Where's my lightsaber? There it is. Wait, did I have this in the thing? I'm pretty sure I didn't. I need to test it on single player. But look at this. This was kind of capture the flag. I don't remember this mission as well, but... So how does this work? I forget. Remember this dueling, but I don't remember how it works. Okay, and this is teleport thing. Right, and you had these pickups everywhere. Cool. And look at this up there. This is so like a post-Doom, you know, Star Wars game.
The gold flag has been taken.
There we go. So I have the gold flag. See?
The red team is in the lead.
And this is a dark surge of force power. This random ammo everywhere. Which gun is that? This is the crossbow. And you could load it. Where's the loading? Oh no, it's bounced. Okay. Right. Wow. This thing. And this is very Doom. Check this out. Yeah, this is, this is called Star Wars Jedi Knight, and then I don't... For me, this was Jedi Knight, right?
The gold flag is captured.
Brrr.
The red team is in the lead.
Wow, I played this a lot. Can't I damage myself with this? Apparently not. Cool. Wow. The old days, guys. All right, let's play something that's slightly more playable. This is a bit too much. Wow.
Yeah, I want to leave this game. Thank you. All right. Wow. Let's return our screen to normal. There we go. You go away. You go away. All right. Yeah, this was Jedi Knight Dark Forces 2. This was a game from 97. Wow. Those were the days, guys. Those were the Star Wars days we fell in love with. And this is, you know, such old memories for me, like from loving the world and everything. But yeah, this was when I was 12, I played this and up, right? I played this for a couple of years. And again, this was the first game I ever modded. I remember downloading over my 56.6 KB connection, like 70 megs, which was like crazy at that time, downloading this much data for one game. Your favorite of those was Jedi Outcast. This one, Jedi Outcast. Let's see here if I remember this one. So this, let's not play this or anything, but this was Jedi Outcast. Oh, okay. This was 2003, so slightly later. There were a lot of games in this fashion made. I don't think I played this one. This one is a bit too neat for my memory. I don't remember these graphics specifically. Oh yeah, and that's where you played with Thrawn and everything. I remember pictures from this game, but I haven't played it, I believe. Yeah, it was made like Jedi Academy. All these games are basically the same. It's Kyle Katarn versus the world, and he's either doing like a... is either doing a sort of FPS shooter thing with Star Wars weapon, which was just really cool, Wookiee crossbow or the you know, Empire repeaters and all those kind of things, or it was just flinging a lightsaber at everybody's direction. Was let's look how many there are here. Academy is very familiar to everybody. KOTOR is something else, but we had Dark Forces 2, that's what I just loaded up. Dark Forces even older? I don't think I played Dark Forces. Maybe we'll try and boot this one up. And we have Quarter 1 maybe was a continuation of this. Yeah, there's not enough old games in here. A lot of them are not here, of course. But yeah, these games... I'm gonna try and boot this up, okay, guys? This, I'm not sure it will be playable at all, but let's try. Special edition, sure, yeah. Because this game, this is true nostalgia for me. This is, I played a lot. There you go, joystick. I'm not sure I can play it without a joystick. It needs a CD. Look at the prompts it's sending me. These games I've played a lot, these fighter games, right? Well, maybe I have to have joystick for this. Maybe we can play the X-Wing one. Let's try the X-Wing one. Special edition, sure. Yeah, joystick. It wants my joystick. I believe maybe we can launch a different version. Just I'm gonna launch it without being on the screen because we might be getting some weird pop-ups. Okay. Is this working? Ooh. Wait. But you gotta. Oh, come on! Don't do this to me. Change something in my stream, but this is older, guys. This is older. Oh god, The meaty sounds, guys. So this is set during the actual rebellion. I just want to see if there's a cutscene. I don't want to cut it off for you. These are the cutscenes. These were the cutscenes of the day.
The Empire is on the verge of success. Soon, peace and order will be restored throughout the galaxy.
See how amazing this art is.
Even now, our capable forces, led by Darth Vader, are striking back at the rebel insurgents.
The scales
are unprepared for our attack. Signal Vice Admiral Thrawn to launch his TIE squadrons immediately.
Right. This is getting too long, and you are watching a tiny screen, guys.
This Thrawn stronghold has no hope of escape.
Oh, geez, I'm so captured in it. Wait, is it gonna throw us into action immediately? Okay, enough of this. It's too much, guys. It's too much. Jeez, okay. Lower the fucking volume as well. Hold on, let me try and fix that. You guys will be hearing it in the background, sorry. Let's just reduce the volume to nothing. Ugh. Whew! That was something. Okay. Let me try and fix my screen capture here. Maybe I can properly do this now. God damn it. Because I'm doing display capture instead of game capture, which I'm usually am doing. And what it's doing, it's fucking up the resolution every time I do this. So let's do, like, maybe a new one would work. Let's try this one. Capture the specific window. Here we go. Dust box. Let's try this. This might work. Okay. This might work. Is this working? Let's see. Ooh. Maybe? Center joystick. Yeah, this is not gonna work. Oh, it is working. Well, it's working in menu. I would love to show you the menu of this. If this is actually gonna work for us. Because this was something. The level of investment they did for this. You gotta see it. You really gotta see it. Alright, let's... capture any full screen application, maybe. Maybe that would work. Help. And it's full screen. Capture it. Capture it. I dare you. Oh, for fuck's sake. Yeah. Maybe I should have prepared for this a bit. Let's listen to the amazing MIDI sounds. Oh, this is something. So this game is basically crazy atmospheric. You start on the fleet ship, as you'll see at some point, and you basically... let's do auto. There we go. Looking for a game for me to capture. Hopefully this will work. Hello? Capture it! You bastard. No, it's not doing it. It's refusing. Pod racing. Ah, oh, that was one. You're right. You're right, Drew. But yeah, I'm not sure we'll be able to do this one. Jeez, this is annoying. Where's the hotkey? For scaling. Okay, let's try it. I'm not sure this is gonna work. No, it's not working. Sorry guys, this is really annoying me. Okay, we'll do display capture. What can we do? Okay, so can we scale this up? Is there a menu inside here? Let's see now. These are the graphics, guys. This is the graphic setting. You see this? 640 on 480 or 320 on 200. I'm sure some of you never saw these numbers in their life. This is something. Wow. Yeah. Jeez. Okay. DOS. Ugh. Wow, you launched this game from DOS. Okay, let's give it a try. No, it's gonna do that scaling thing again. Why does it do this? Yeah, I'm sorry guys. I'm really sorry. I thought this would work for me. But apparently old games are much harder to work out than this. Even for Steam. I thought these games were like, you know, working with Windows. Apparently they're not. Not as much, at least. As I would want. Okay, let's try last time. Last time. We're gonna try. Okay. Let's do specific window. We're gonna do the DOS box one. What else are we doing for scaling? Sure, whatever. Let's try it. Alright, let's try it. Okay. Will it read it now? No, you guys are not seeing it, unfortunately. Oh, I'm getting so mad. Okay, well, I'm gonna do the same stupid thing I did earlier, just to show you guys this. Sorry. We'll have to stretch out the window in a weird ass way in order to show you guys this properly. This is really weird. Let's try this one for size. Rip old games for sure, yeah. Okay. Okay, we got this. This is reasonable, right? Okay. So let's say Oyster. Right? Accessing Oyster, right? Alright. Look at this amazing intro screen, right? You write up down your name, it says, okay, this is your level, cool, nice, wonderful. And then you get in. And you got this. This is the menu, alright? Oh, I so miss this thing. Alright. So there's a fill room here to watch cutscenes, right? Mission files and such. Load mission file, okay. I don't have a mission, I guess, right? Tech room. Alright, here we go. You can watch the different types of fighters that you got. Right, this is how I learned all the names of the crafts. Alright, TIE Advanced. You got Look at this, like stats and everything, the assault gunboat, TIE Defender, and there you go, enemy ships. You played the Empire in this one. This was the first game. This was TIE Fighter, the first game, and then came out X-Wing, which was slightly more modern, but they basically were the same game. But X-Wing was much less cool. It tried to do the same thing, but somehow the Empire graphics, the pixel art in it, and also the feel of the ship was much better in my opinion. I played both these games to holy hell though. I played a lot of them. And you could collect medals, maybe I can show you these. Combat chamber. Alright, there you go. Alright, this is the movie. Learn to use your sensor and a different cockpit view while you practice your gunnery skills against fixed targets. I'm probably not going to be able to fly at all, though. That's the problem. I think... How do I leave this place? Exit... Exit simulator. New battle. Training simulator. There used to be an area with... medals and stuff, but I guess when you don't have any, it doesn't let you access it. At some point, you move to a different place, right? Alright, new battle. The Hoth system, alright? And there you go. Battle 1, Mission 1. The aftermath of the Hoth. Pursue rebels fleeing from Hoth, right? So you can do, like, several battles. Battle 2... See, these are like crazy epic fights and that you can join, and then you start doing like a series of missions, and once you've done them, they give you like a medal for the battle and stuff like that. It's really cool. Let's try the combat chamber. I'm pretty sure I can't play it just because I don't have a joystick connected. So we got several missions here. Let's enter briefing.
In this mission, you will learn the basic gunnery.
This is the briefing you would get in this game. Fixed targets. This is so cool. Alright, so you get like stages. And if you want, you could stop this. And you could like, where's the rewind one? Rewind briefing.
In this mission, you will learn the basic gunnery skills of targeting, aiming at, and destroying fixed targets.
Show me a modern game that lets you do this kind of thing. Just a simple thing. Just controlling your own briefing of a thing. Just because you're supposed to be the pilot who controls the screen and views his own briefing. It's so cool.
Your piloting ability to maneuver with and engage moving targets.
I wish they would make a modern version of this game, but you know, obviously it's not gonna work.
You may continue at your option to one-on-one dogfighting contests of increasing difficulty.
Yeah. And then after it the one-on-one keeps going.
Encounters, you will face multiple enemies as the odds increase against you.
Yeah, I remember this. I would stay for a long ass time until they defeated me. Flight. At this point.
Alpha 1, don't touch anything until told to.
Oh, okay, my mouse works. Okay.
Hit the T key to target the container in front of you.
There we go. Oh, so classic.
Target 1 will turn yellow to indicate it is the current target. Your targeting box will turn green to indicate a good shot.
See?
Fire at will to destroy target 1. It should take 8 hits.
Alpha 1 target destroyed.
Press the T key to target the next container.
This is so Star Wars for me.
Hit the 9 key to see your right forward view.
Alright, so you could change your views. Return like on the keypad. So you could watch the different views. Like we're looking in mirrors, kinda.
To the right toward the bracketed target.
There we go. This was so smart for the day.
Continue until you have destroyed all of the containers. Reset your laser recharge rate to maintain a full charge by pressing the F9 key.
Right, so one of the best mechanics in here was if you're looking. Oh, why did I press? Oh shit, sorry guys. Okay, there we go. I shouldn't press the keypad. Alright, so one of the best things about this, if you look to the left and right of the screen, you'll see these energy bars. You could change like the amount that you would give out to lasers, and like the general energy would deplete. And when you had shields, you also had to compensate for that. And of course your speed, the rest of the energy for your speed will decrease. So you basically play between shields, lasers, and speed. So when my laser charge is just middle, it won't recharge my laser. So now, if you can see, I have my laser recharged, and I got like two layers, right? If it's like this, my lasers will stay the same. If I do it like nothing, the lasers will actually get depleted. You can see one line is already getting depleted pretty fast. And here it will deplete less fast, but it will still deplete. So you kinda, you can switch and aim your different power settings. So they wanted me to have it like this at least in order to be able to recharge lasers. You can see the hull stats and systems of everything here. This was like the father of all, you know, games of this type, like dogfighters and you know, especially space simulators for fighter fighting and stuff like that. How'd I go to 2/3 throttle? I don't remember. There we go. This is one, this is two, okay. And one is three, I don't remember. Oh well. Okay. So we're preparing to engage this target. There he is. R key. Okay.
To match speed with the target, press the return key.
Yeah, okay, right. So I go on his tail, and you have this indicator. There we go. And I need not to get too close to the station, that's what I remember.
Will increase your challenge.
How do I do full power? Full power, there we go. Alright, copy that. Now, these guys don't even shoot at me. I think they're just, yeah, mover they're called. So they're just moving targets. I need not to hit their station because then it's going to wail at me. I remember that. Look at this. So cool. Oh, this is nice. All right. So we're going to get five movers and then they're going to start. We're going to have one line of attackers that we'll need to destroy in order to complete the tutorial. And then it's going to start giving us like challenges, right? Get some lines of attackers that are an increasing difficulty, basically. Now, I'm a TIE fighter, so I'm quite quick. So I'm going to match my speed with him. And then you can just stay behind him like this. Alright, next mover. Let's go 2/3. Oh, this is bringing back memories. I didn't have a joystick back then either at some point. Until I got X-Wing, and then I got a joystick because you kind of had to have one. And boy, did we wail on that thing. Okay, so we completed the mission. Very nice. And now we're staying, it's waiting a bit for us to stay, and then it's gonna launch a new Z95 Headhunter, which is like the prototype for the X-Wing. It was like the ship that the X-Wing was prototyped from. This is like an old fighter. So now it's flying proper speeds and everything. I'm flying very fast toward him, of course. Whoa! Okay, here we go. Almost crashed into him there. Matching speed. Here we go. Destroyed. And they just show up immediately now. This is kind of a explode thing. You can kind of shoot them when they leave the hangar. Because if they take a while to start up. Right? You just... If you stay put here, you can basically shoot them down one by one. If you match speed with them. Here we go. There's the new boy. But they're gonna start responding faster and faster to this. I need higher sensitivity on the mouse. Set that. There we go. Alright, we destroyed 5. And now it's gonna start getting ranked up. This was Fighter 5. So this is Dyad 1. Oh, right, I'm fighting couples and then triads. Yeah, okay. Now I remember. It's gonna be a numbers thing. So we fought 1, now we're gonna fight couples until we finish all of those. And then triples. And this is how you would train dogfighting a bit. Okay. Well, I'm good. So let's... how do I end the mission? There we go. You press Q and spacebar. So such an old style thing. Okay, there you go. It will give you out your stuff, your
you have
thingies.
Shown you are capable of engaging enemy craft in gunnery combat.
And the voice for this, for the officers, is such like the British voices that they did in the movies. It was pretty amazing. Debriefing by officer. Question 1 of 2. Debrief me on my mission, sir. And it gives out this thing, and then what have I accomplished? Amazing. Okay, let's exit the debriefing. And we're gonna skip the rest of these missions. We're gonna just go for battle. Let's do a battle, guys. Join battle. Alright, so now we're in a different screen. As you can see, we got enter mission, return to concourse, which was like the main ship there. Or we can view the mission map. Let's do that.
One TIE fighter from Alpha, Beta, and Gamma squadrons will be out on patrol around Outpost D-34.
There we go.
Your mission is to inspect all cargo-carrying vessels as they pass by our station. We are on the lookout for rebel forces that are fleeing from their base on Hoth. One TIE fighter from Alpha, Beta,
that's
and
it.
Gamma squadrons.
Okay, so basically, they give you a very simple defense mission. Just scan the ships, right? Obviously, it's going to go haywire. You're going to find some rebels. There we go. So you can actually talk to them. Look at this graphic.
All cargo
and voice for everything.
To accomplish
just
this, target each freighter
amazing
and
game.
Transport. Then fly close enough for your ship's sensors to determine what cargo the vessel has on board.
There we go.
Check your progress on the mission goals screen, toggled by hitting the G key.
There you go.
You will fly the TIE fighter designated
Alpha 1. Mm-hmm.
You will be the only craft in your flight group.
They always give you that information, so you might be a flight group leader, you might be, you know, a co-pilot, a wingman, you know, stuff like that. Stay alert for radio transmissions, you can press L, okay. What a position it will be.
Has been above normal in this area. We think this is related to the retreat of rebel forces in the aftermath
this
of our attack on their
so immersive.
Stay alert for rebels hidden amongst the freighter convoys.
So amazing. Thank you, sir. Alright, let's fly, guys. Let's fly. Alright. Ooh, immediately into the mission. No freaking loading chance.
They're entering the area near Boyd B-18. TIE Fighter Alpha 1, inspect all craft. Freighters requesting permission to pass through this sector. Transport
here they are.
Permission.
Okay, I need to fly slower. I need to fly much slower. Well, no, I don't need to fly much slower. Actually, I need to fly at them full of power. There we go. Let's go scan them. Which one is closest? Right, hold on. So I need to scan Wonis and Dita. Need to scan all of them. So let's start with bonus one. Getting close to him. Well, actually, we can scan these guys first, because they're close, right? All right. Dita 1, Dita 2, let's scan it. Workers, okay. Okay, let's scan this one. Food stuff. Bonus two is this one. Food stuff. Bonus three is over here. Rebels. All right. Transport Sigma. Okay, so.
Illegal cargo located.
Okay, so what do we need to do? Freighter Onus 3 must be captured. Okay.
You know, one of the freighters.
Must be captured. So we don't destroy it.
Imperial transports are being dispatched to board the freighter.
Yeah, copy that. Let's scan this and Onus 5. Let's scan that one too. Okay.
Super Scan. Alpha 1. Primary mission objectives completed. The Emperor will be pleased. The first wave of freighters and transports has been inspected. Good work.
Good work.
Help with the capture operation or return to base. Job well done, Alpha 1.
Very good. So, we can help with the capture.
The shuttles have not identified themselves. Fighters, beware of enemy shuttles. Alpha 1, help the transports weaken the freighter's shields.
Okay, copy that. So you see, we can quit the mission now, or we can help weaken the shields, give some power to laser recharge, because we're about to deplete our laser. You can hear the different sound here. Get full power to lasers, and shields are out.
Target.
Here we go. There we go. Do I have enemies? Yes, we have enemies. Is this an enemy? It's not identified itself. Oh, okay, 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 okay. Hello. Transport Data 1. Alright, Data 1, let's go scan it.
Capture operation begun.
Nope, I don't see another. Okay. Well, let's just kill them, I guess, then. These shuttles are bigger than me. I need to be careful not to crash into them. Alright, last one. Oh! I've been destroyed. Okay. Not good. Okay, so we didn't scan a secondary goal. We had two other groups to be coming in, but we did manage. There we go. We've been taken to a secluded prison planet. You see, this is what happens when you die. Look at this immersion. I'm gonna be in a Bacta tank, or am I a prisoner? Prisoner, okay. Apparently they captured me. Your pilot has been restored. Okay. So that means that I was captured and I can't continue. I have to do the mission again, I think.
One TIE fighter from Alpha, Beta, and Gamma squadrons.
This is amazing.
Will be out on patrol.
Look at this amazing game. Okay, I'm so happy we got into this one. Alright, let's leave this thing. DOS, which basically means exit the game, right? Go to back to DOS. Jeez. What a game. What a game, guys. Unfortunately, the screen problems are horrible, but yeah, I might have played a bit more if so. I want you guys to be able to see in full screen, though. Your early Star Wars education. Drew sent me a picture. He has CDs of Clone Wars, Jedi Starfighter, and what's the third one? Racer. Oh, that's the Pod Racer. It's Revenge, though. Is it a different one than the actual Pod Racer, man? Because I played the original one. It was much later game than the one we're looking at now, right? But yeah. Wow, guys. Wow. These games. TIE Fighter. It's the same, but it got a different name on PlayStation, right? So the game we just played is from 94, right? 94. I was 9 when it came out. And that game was just crazy. That game, and as well, if you can see, let's do... there we go. That game, and of course, the X-Wing game. X-Wing Special Edition. I got it down here. You guys can't see because the screen is crazy, but yeah, there you go. This one, X-Wing Special Edition. This one was like 95. When was it? Let's see. No, it's 94 as well. They came out the same year. Oh, amazing. Such amazing stuff. Yeah. This is pretty much the same. You can see from the graphics. I mean, they tried a bit harder on this one. They, like, I guess they had some lessons from it, and I played it a lot. X-Wing as well. There's the briefing. You see the our old general explaining the briefing and everything. So cool. A little bit of better graphics, as you can see. But man, oh man, just flying across huge, you know, capital ships and destroying all the little cannons so they can't shoot you. Great stuff. I really had fun during this period of Star Wars gaming. All right, so let's progress a bit, shall we? We played Dark Forces 2 a bit. Dark Forces is what year, I wonder? Because Dark Forces 2 is 97. This is 95, right? So can you see some gameplay here? Not really. Just there we go. Okay, there's a bit of gameplay. There's a bit of gameplay here. Yeah, it's pretty much the same. Even more clunky. 15 energy units. Lol. Alright. Right. So, we were doing Star Wars. Come on. Steam. Don't start with me. Okay. So, there's a lot of stuff not installed here, Force Unleashed. Of course, a lot of you have played it, this much newer game. Amazing stuff. I played it on Nintendo Wii, which I gotta say was a great experience. Like, waving your hands like this with, like, the Wii nunchuck. It was pretty good. I enjoyed that. Unleashed 2 I haven't really played, I gotta say. It was kind of a bit too much for me. Clone Wars. So this is the one that you're talking about? Clone Wars Republic Heroes? This is an awful game. I don't know if this is one of the ones you were playing, Drew. But this is an awful game. And it has, I think, ratings to match. Right? Let's check it. Yeah. Mostly negative. Look at this piece of crap of a game. This is a horrible game. But, you know, if you grew up on it, I can't blame you for loving it or not, you know. Check this stupid shit out, though. It's based on the Clone Wars series, the early days of it, so 2009. And you could, I guess, co-op? That's why we're seeing both Obi-Wan and Anakin here. It's cute. But yeah, it was horrible to play. I remember trying to play it. It doesn't look so bad in this cutscene, actually, I gotta say, but I remember playing it. It was pretty horrible. There was a lot of jumping puzzles that were really awkward because of the angles that you were watching yourself doing them, and the combat was so repetitive that it was just really annoying. So there we go into these guys. These, for those of you who don't know, these are the Quarter games, Knight of the Old Republic, right? These games were the shit, right? These were the Skyrim of Star Wars back in the day. Especially Quarter 2, which was even more successful than the first one. This was a proper RPG. Well, it wasn't the sandbox as much because it was quite linear, but you could explore a bit. You could explore, and you definitely had inventory management. You can buy whatever you want. You could choose if you're going to the light or the dark side in this one. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Fallen Order, we played it this year. Great game. My dream is to have a Star Wars, sandbox RPG. I really want that. I was quite disappointed when it came out as a linear story game. It's not that I didn't enjoy it, but, you know, when finally a new good Star Wars that's not like multiplayer dedicated EA bullshit came out, I wanted more than 40 hours in it. And 40 hours was me being a completionist about it. You see, I played 38 hours. I was being completionist. I just completed 100% of the game. If there were achievements for it, which there are still not achievements, you would see I have completed everything. Actually, I have some screenshots here. Are those the one who show that? Yeah, I took screenshots of me having everything on every planet. Right. Yeah, you see, three secrets, five chests, explored, and I did this for every planet, just to kind of because there's no other way to show that you've done everything. I think I read that in Xbox you would get like an Xbox tag thing popping up, but not on this. Jedi Academy. This was the pinnacle of like the Kyle Katarn age. It was a pretty successful game and had a multiplayer scene, which I also got into slightly. But yeah. You see, this is the pinnacle of it. 2003, right? These games came up to the end of them. They started 94, we said. No, 95. 95 these games started. And in 2003, this was the pinnacle of it. Like the Jedi adventure. You become a Jedi. You can go light side or dark side, kind of. Before it came really big in KOTOR, when it actually opened up to being a full RPG sandbox, it was this. And this was a full story mode. You came into the Jedi Academy, that was formed by Skywalker, and you've studied, and, you know, as per usual, somebody became dark side, and things went to shit. But you could actually semi-customize it. This was precursor KOTOR stuff, but it wasn't still that open, right? And then we had stuff like, where is it? Republic Commando, right? This was a full FPS for clones. People went crazy for it. They're still waiting for the continuation game. Like, people are rooting for it to have a sequel, right? It doesn't, though. And we got the Battlefront games, the old ones. I think the first one has been removed from Steam, and the second one has been blocked for multiplayer after people went into it instead of the new Battlefront, right? But you can see that it says Battlefront 2 Classic 2005, because there's already a Battlefront 2 now here, but this is the better one. This is definitely the better one. Is this like a video from somebody? Let's see here. Yeah, this is how it looks, pretty much. I'm not gonna launch the game. I don't have it installed even, Because you can't really do anything in it and just like run around and against bots now. But you had the galaxy, you could do fights all over the galaxy. So much more immersive in the menu and like the options that you got than our current Battlefront, which you will see in a bit. You could do this strategy thing. This is like a turn-based strategy game that you could do. Try to manage the Clone Wars fight. You know, and do like ship movements and stuff like that. So there's somebody videoing himself, I guess, playing. And you can see he just went into this thing. He didn't need to spawn it. And you just run around and start engaging. And you could manage your own fight in it. It's just really amazing. And let's just say that EA fucked everything up they touch. Yeah, well, not everything they touch. They do have some good titles. We'll give them that. But they fucked up Star Wars. They fucked up Star Wars majorly. That's for sure. They blocked it from having any story content for like the duration of the time that they control the franchise, which is for some time now. And they focused it on multiplayer market, which of course we all know the famous saying of an executive there. Single player is dead, you know. What the people want now is multiplayer, and that's what they try to do. A multiplayer with loot crates, right? Buy some loot crates, get some pre-purchase and some loot crate content. We'll get more money, and people can buy themselves an easy win. And they think that's what the gamer community wants. And I'm so happy that gamers finally boycotted this bullshit when Battlefront 2 came out. But look, this is an amazing game. This was a really, really great game. I played these with my siblings. Those were really great games. The first one as well, and not only the second one. The second one is just the latest. So they basically were the same game, except like upgraded graphics and even more options. Like the first one didn't have the TBS stuff, like the turn-based strategy thing. And you got some more flying simulator here that came afterwards, Starfighter, and which one do I have installed? Alliance. Alliance was a good one that came after. You were playing, actually, this was a more story-based one. You were playing, this was your home, your room in the thing, right? And you were playing this sort of son of a traitor, and you had a whitey, a Corellian ship that was like one class different than what Han Solo flies, the Millennium Falcon. And you would start in that, and then you would join the rebellion and change your ship and do all kind of things. This guy, I guess, did a screenshot of him having all the medals. But this was like a very familiar thing from X-Wing and TIE Fighter titles. We could collect stuff like this. So you could see the robot got a medal, and you had all these marking on your helmets because of successful battles or kills. And you got all these weird items, right, hanging around. And this was like a part of the menu. It's a so immersive part of those old games, especially since it was all like really beautiful pixel art. You were proud of every medal back in those days. And yeah, let's return to our days today. I was kind of thinking maybe I'm gonna play Empire at War, which is a pretty cool strategy game if you don't know it. This one is not that old, and you can do some cool stuff in it. It's basically an RTS inside a TBS. It's basically like you play grand strategy on the Empire map, and then individual battles are just RTS battles with the forces that you had, right? So you would either do space fights that look like this. Why is this in German? I don't know. I guess the guy has translation on his thing. And you could actually do pretty cinematic battles. Because the ships would fight themselves, right? You would give maybe general orders, but the ships would fight themselves. So you could actually kind of watch the battles pretty nicely. And then, like, manage them. There you go. Like, equip planets and manage them and all that kind of stuff. It's a really cool game. If you like Star Wars and you want to get immersive in the experience, this is the one. By the way, part of the reason I'm showing you all of this, guys, is because today is May the 4th and you got 40% on everything, right? So if you want to get some of these old, really cinematic titles and play with them, especially if you have a joystick and you want to really enjoy some cool old space simulators, you know, my recommendations are definitely TIE Fighter and X-Wing. I'm gonna return to these games. I need to get myself a joystick. Maybe I'll even stream some of it. This should be really cool. But these are games that I'm gonna let my children play, right? These are really, really cool old games. And of course, KOTOR, KOTOR 2, and this, Empire at War, Battlefront. Really, really good games, you know. There's a lot of shit Star Wars games out there as well. If you like the Lego games, which a lot of people do, there's Star Wars Lego as well. I'm not in my library, right? But there's some Star Wars Lego. And yeah, let's actually look at the list for a second. What am I not seeing from my library? So we got... Yeah, Battlefront. I don't have, like, the first Battlefront in Steam. I bought the second Battlefront on Steam, but I had these two in CDs. These were not things I had in on Steam back in the day. Of course, neither of these, right? But bought, like, the big package of Star Wars at some point. Apparently, there's Star Wars Pinball now. I don't know what that even means, but sure. And the Lego Star Wars games that I don't own, but definitely go for it. Podracer, I don't know why I don't own that. I guess it wasn't part of the package. I did play it a lot. I don't remember if we had it on the PlayStation or if we had it on the PC. But I played it a lot. This is also a really fun game. Really, really fun game. You could customize your Podracer and fix it and upgrade it and... It could play different pilots from the movie, and like they expanded on it a bit as well. And it was really fun flying through these crazy maps. Very fast action for all of this. And there was, of course, the part where you would fix your pod mid-air because it would malfunction and all that kind of stuff. Because of course that was a big part in the movie, so they had to do it in the game, which, you know, I'm not against. Star Wars Galactic Battlegrounds. Oh, this is an old the old RTS one. This is also really, really great. Like the old version of the one that I just showed you, Rebel 1 and 2. I haven't played those. Those are look like really old games. That combine like third-person shooter and some weird stuff, and more pinball stuff, Shadows of the Empire. Yeah, that's another one of those, Katarn style. Rogue Squadron. Yeah, that's another flyer. Cool. All right, we're leaving Steam. Leaving it behind, and let's open the cursed the cursed Origin player, guys. I updated the game earlier, so hopefully we'll have no more malfunctions in this. And let's play the new generation of Star Wars, which I gotta say, after the game was boycotted horribly, it actually became semi-decent. I mean, it still is missing the immersion of these old games that we just seen. Definitely missing it. And it's not that hard, like, doing the menus better and you know, giving that immersive feel to all of it. I wish they do this these days, that somebody would bring it back and do this kind of style, right? And they don't, unfortunately. But they upgraded it a lot, and they definitely worked on adding more stuff to it, which I respect. Because at least they tried, you know. And you gotta give credit when credit is due. And when I finally bought the game, it still was in kind of a bad shape. And I definitely can say that it has changed and evolved into something much more enjoyable. It still has a lot of problems. The biggest one being that because it was boycotted, it doesn't have enough players to fit the model of matchmaking that they have. Because they have a lot of game modes that are nice and are just completely unplayable most of the time because no players are queuing up for them. Because all players are really trying to queue up for the big battles. So yeah. You can't really do a squad with friends. A lot of things like that. It's really annoying. But yeah. The game has its benefits, for sure. Mainly the big fights are atmospheric as they should be in Battlefront, like as was in the old Battlefront days. And yeah. The music is great. The graphics are really good. Weapons feel pretty good, most of them. And they're really trying to do customization that says non-paid customization, right, for things, which look nice. You can see it on the screen. That's the new title screen. The loading times, as you can see, is still pretty horrible. Yeah, but that's the game. Come on, game. We are talking about you. Do try to perform a bit better for people. But yeah, speaking of Star Wars, guys, like, apart from any questions you might have or topics you want to bring up, the new season of Clone Wars is out. And I gotta say, I was... Well, the first few episodes, like 4 or 5 episodes, are a story that I already knew. So I wasn't that excited about it. I couldn't really get that excited about it just because it was not... you know, it wasn't like getting new stories, right? But it still was really good seeing it designed properly and done well. Why do I have all these things? Apparently I have something for Palpatine appearance. Apparently I got some gifts. Sith Eternal. Okay, cool. Apparently I can look like this now. Look at him. These are like his indoor robes, right? That's his creepy robe. Rey, like I'm ever gonna play that. What do we have? Rey Skywalker. Sure. Yeah, just out of spite. No. No Rey Skywalker. Please no. Oh jeez, those movies. But yeah, we're talking about good stuff. So the Clone Wars series, once the Ahsoka line started, it was slightly boring at start, I gotta say, but it became much better. Much better as it goes on. And it's right now at a really, really interesting junction. I'm not gonna spoil anything, really, but yeah. Pretty intense. I'm looking forward. It's starting to get me, you know. What did we get? Okay, First Order. Apparently, some stuff from the new movie got updated. So we now have a First Order snow trooper, right? I would rather be a normal trooper, to be honest. And a Galactic Empire. Oh, okay. We finally got the old snow troopers. And... the Shoret Trooper. Oh, I like this one. This one is from the best movie of the new generation. Best. Rogue One, guys. This is the movie of of this generation, right? That's a proper Star Wars movie. And it's better than many of the older movies. Really better in every sense, I gotta say. Okay, cool. Let's see what other outfits they added. This is nice, coming in and receiving gifts. So we got the Sand Trooper. Oh, that's classic. This is Tatooine. Right? The Tatooine Cops. These are like basically Star Wars versions of sheriffs or deputies. Like they just scan the desert and abuse the locals. It's really funny. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Okay, maybe some update on this. So we got this officer, which is basically a vehicle officer. I don't know why we get him specifically. We got a Shoret trooper as an officer, I guess. Sure, it looks much better, gotta say. So let's do that. And what do we have for a specialist? Ooh, we have a lot of them. Okay. So we got a Shoret trooper as for a specialist. Nah, I like this. The scout type, and right from fucking what's the fucking name of it? The Mandalorian, right? The Mandalorian, the amazing comedy beat between those two, that was amazing. I think one of the best parts of the last episode, which had a lot of good parts in it. All right, we got Zabrak stuff. Cool. Let's be a Zabrak. Why not? The lighter side of Zabrax, of course. Why not? Cool. Okay. Alright, let's play, shall we? We're doing customization, obviously. We got no unopened chests that I know of. Yeah. There's no more chests, really. This was their store. At the start, now there's nothing here for ages now. Which is good. We don't need any more chests or anything like that. So now the mod everybody's playing is... It used to be... where is it? It used to be Galactic Assault. And now they're pushing Supremacy really hard. Let's do Galactic Assault because it's shorter. Maybe let's see if there's still players in that. I hope there are, because Galactic Assault is still really good. Yeah, still is very populated, it seems. Not everybody likes Supremacy. And also, Supremacy battles can be really, really long. Feed. Let's play on Feed. Oh, I love this map. This is one of the best maps. And I always hope I'm the clones, of course, but playing the robots is also kind of fun. Separatists for the win, right? Are we joining or not? Come on. Let's go. Alrighty. So what are we playing? We need to push our specialist to level 35. That's why we have all these points. Let's start as a specialist. Alright, we came up to the start of the match. Well, apparently it's just Galactic Republic, or I'm only seeing my team. I usually don't look at the numbers. I was just interested to see how many players there are. Don't leave. This is not gonna start. Leave. Okay. Well, apparently people are... Oh, players needed, right. People are leaving. Yeah, you see? Matchmaking issues. Matchmaking issues. The game is not starting because everybody for some reason joined the same team. Is this a bug or is there actually not enough players? Because I'm seeing 20 players, but they keep on coming in and out. I guess one whole team is missing. Yeah, we're not going to wait for this. Very unfortunate though. This is the bane of this game right now. And that's why it's not worth getting, I gotta say. Even though it's improved a lot, and it's Star Wars content. Ooh, this is new. I can choose the age. Okay, so probably because everybody's playing only Supremacy, I can actually choose which age I want to fight in. Age of the Republic, please. Thank you. Kashyyyk. Right. Good, good, good. So yeah. The game is not worth it, I think, at the moment. Especially not the high price tag that EA holds it up in. Because all you get is basically out of this whole supposed package, this is what you get. Supremacy battles that are very limited to specific locations. Although now they added apparently different ages and stuff. But yeah, with people that most of them, like me, already play this game a bunch. So they have already upgraded these things. They have upgraded cards, right? And it's not that you can't win without upgraded cards, but upgraded cards help, right? And yeah, it's just not the best. Not something that you should really pay for that much, for sure. There's somebody here. Oh! Oh! Ah, crap. Took me too long to see him. Alright, I need to get used to the game again. Let's defend a juggernaut. I really like these juggernauts. I have very fond feelings toward them. Now, they beef these battles with bots, which is fair enough, I gotta say. If it's immersive, it's fine. The old Battlefronts were like that as well. But I don't know. Maybe because it's EA, I always get the feeling that they're trying to push it without us knowing, you know? They definitely changed some of the graphics, though. I appreciate that. The interface is a bit different. Okay, do we have G? There we go. Anything to shoot from here, actually? I'm not sure about that, no. This is like one of the things. These gun positions are useless. Why not fix it and make them something useful? Change their position, maybe. And increase the protection that somebody gets when they're on it, so they don't get sniped immediately. Oh! And Anakin came and cut my head off. And also, these heroes are slightly too much sometimes. Which I guess they should be kind of too much, but I don't know. I'm not sure I'm a fan of the exact mechanics. Don't have any offers to improve it, though, I gotta admit. Especially Yoda, very hard to hit. Well, apparently I'm squad leader, so I need to give orders. They definitely improved the interface there. Murderated. Well, we got the option of playing a ball. I always would like to play a ball. Roll out! Now, this is like an addition to the game. This wasn't at the start, for sure. And they added some amazing characters like this one. And I'm really enjoying this. Look at this thing! I mean, I can't do much with it, but it's amazing. Oh no! Don't murder me! Aww. Poor robot. Yeah, I'm not on my game today. Yeah, but the points of these battles, if you don't know the supremacy model, basically, we got these 5 capture points. By capping them and killing the enemy, you get percentages. Which you can see on the top, enemy has 52%. Now we have 10. And the first one to get 100% is get to board the other one's ship and make an attempt on destroying its generators. And if that attempt fails, they give you a certain time frame to do so. If that attempt fails, you basically stay on where you got to push on that ship, and the battle returns to this mode. So this fight can last forever, like coming back and forth between the ships until somebody manages to get an edge and slowly push toward the generators in a few fights. And maybe, you know, destroy the enemies. Or there's like completely uneven teams, and the first chance that somebody gets to board the other one's ship, they destroy it immediately. Either way, this is not, you know, this mod is, while interesting, having this as the only mod in the game that works is a problem. Because you're making players commit to fights between half an hour and like an hour and a half or something like that. And this is supposed to be a game that has some quick fights in it, right? Kind of weird. Alright. Let's protect this one. Defend our village. Let's get to the top maybe and try to grab an actual sniper position. Something that I might have done earlier if I was not talking out of my ass. Let's get some targets on. Nice. Okay, 2 tag. No, they're not. Okie dokie. Show me the money. What is shooting down here? Ooh. A lot of sweet targets below us. Shot out of that position, but we got some cool characters to play. There we go. This is a favorite. Let's recapture D. Job. Which button was it to change my... There we go. Let's go murderate them. Locked. is still up here. The Darth Maul really scared me over there. We got some assholes up here. Oh shit, should have ran away. Well, that was fun. Alright, let's stop picking the specialist. Let's pick something I actually enjoy doing. I was trying to get ahead, but to be honest, I don't really need more stuff in this game. We're feeding your roommates. Welcome back. We're playing Battlefront II, the less better one. But the only viable multiplayer one. Oops, I meant to do this. Detonator got us. Alright. Let's keep with the assault. Juggernaut! Are we losing it? Oh shit. Obi-Wan is here, Maul. Come on. Get your revenge, man. You can do it. I believe in you. I mean, I'm not really, but... Maul should get a win, right? Poor guy. We're chasing Obi-Wan, I don't really know why. We are doing it.
General Grievous is here.
Obi-Wan is running that way.
All units,
there he is. Oh, that's Yoda! Oh, go away, Yoda! Goddamn Yoda. We're chasing Obi-Wan, didn't expect to get a Yoda. Alright, let's go to the Wookiee Tower. Is somebody here? Is that Obi-Wan again? Or is it Yoda? Yoda! Yes! We got Yoda! A shotgun to his head! Screw you, Yoda! Alright. Let's go after E.
Attack the objectives. Hostiles have started to capture command post fresh.
Right, we're on. They're on 99%. There we go. They're gonna board their ships now. Here they are. And coming from their capital ship. So now they're gonna board it. We get a chance to shoot at them a bit. This boarding bit doesn't really do anything.
Stop the clones from reaching the transports.
Oh. Go away! Fucking Anakin. Alright. Now I better save my points to the actual fight on the capital ship, to be honest. There they go. All clones are boarded. A grenade inside there. They should all be blowing up in the LAAT. Here they come. So this is our capital ship. I joined the beginning of this, I think, so they haven't attacked us once yet. So that means no damage. They're gonna start from the hangars. There they go. So they're gonna try and breach the hangars into the ship and then get to the generator area where hopefully we will be stopping them. Alright, let's get a murderator droid. The clones have boarded. All units move to defend. And yeah, here we go. First firefight is always pretty Star Wars-y and epic. Because people are just shooting across corridors, which is very much Star Wars. And the scale is always nice. Oh! There's a Wookiee over there. A lot of heroes are at that position. Let's go murderate. This character is really good against is really good against heroes. I did a lot of damage to him even though he killed me then. So that's good. I think I also got a perk for doing damage for heroes.
Zippies are capturing the objectives.
Count Dooku has come to oversee the battle.
Let's roll out of here. This is what I need to learn with this thing. I gotta be a bit more mobile. Go, go, go! Oh, poor ball. Go to the corridor for a second here, because we're being pushed out here. Okay, let's try and get. Oh, we can't get behind them. Oh, that hurt. I'm being cheeky. Oh shit! Couldn't open my shield before they got me. Ah. Well, I tried. I tried. Let's grab a heavy. Feels like we need some more. Oh. We got to the next objective? Yeah. They breached through, unfortunately. Okay. Well, we're out of the hangars. We're now into the corridor fight. Well, to be honest, that kind of happens. It usually doesn't happen that anybody pushes them back from the hangars. But the corridor fight can definitely be a bottleneck. On the other hand, they can just sneak through by to the generators. Here are the generators. Basically, the bad thing about this is the generators were unlocked. So we kind of need both to defend them and push them in the corridors. Which is something that most teams don't really do well. Oh, oh, oh! I didn't actually see that. It was from the corridor there. Come on. Oh. Okay, well, there was an ARC trooper above me, apparently. Darth Maul is really pissed. Yeah, we're losing one of the generators, you see. Somebody snuck through. They're already in here. There's an actual fight in the generator room, which is really not good.
The clones are attacking the target. We must stop them.
I'm on point. Follow me. Sentry guns online.
A Jedi has been spotted. Looks like Kenobi.
Yeah, behind me. Problem when you're in that mode, you can't really move away. Should we take like a super battle droid? Let's do that. Yeah, defend, guys, defend. We lost one generator out of three. I love launching the rocket from this dude. Yes, Obi-Wan. The battle before you, not behind. Killed Obi-Wan. Always good. Oh, the Wookiee got me. Are you kidding? I thought I had him. Oh well. Yes, Dooku. Go finish him. Was caught in between our forces there. Oh, come on! That pistol is so strong. Oh shit. Move away. Let me spawn on you. There you go. No, shit. Flanking. There we go. Get this boy. The enemy's over there, Maul. Yes, let me slice him a bit. Lol, I negated this. There we go. Me and Maul killed this guy. Oh shit! Arc Trooper up there. Is he just standing there the entire match or something? There he is. I think he's just standing up there. That's really annoying. There he is. No, that's a commander. Can I jump up there? I want to jump up to the corridor. Oh, shit. Come on, game. Let me do this. I want to be smart with this. Come on. Oh, damn it. Yeah, they're out of time to destroy our generators. They did a whole bunch of damage, though. They should be happy with themselves. Oh. Well, we did some damage. And Anakin doesn't get to be Anakin anymore. Because we are leaving this place. Come on, no overtime. Don't give them overtime. Thank you. Alright, so we're back to the battlefield down there. And already this feels like this game mode should have concluded by now, right? Well, it isn't. I mean, I enjoy the scale. And it's kind of immersive to have these long battles, but I gotta say, they're not engaging enough, like in a story manner, that you want to play this for an hour and a half. I gotta say. In this way, they really messed up with this game mode. I mean, maybe some conditions to make it shorter. Because this game mode is all, you know, it's not the only thing, but it's definitely part of the phenomena that's blocking the game from having other game modes. If players are tied for an hour and a half in this kind of thing, they're not going to queue up for any other game mode. Makes sense, right? Ooh. Aw, come on, sentry mode. I want a sentry mode, this bitch. Alright. Let's go back there. Come on, come on. Juggernaut, we're losing it. I want to sentry mode that vehicle. Did it blow up? Oh, I'm being sniped from behind. Let's find a sniper. Maybe capture this. Assault the objective. Oh, I punched him first. Come on. Come on, game. What you playing at? Juggernaut is lost. No? Is it stabilized? But it was lost. Is that vehicle on the other side or is it dead? No, it's not here. Probably died. We're doing okay. Somebody in the top floor. There he is. I think. I think I saw him. No? Well, I don't see anybody here now. Let's go. Getting points for playing the objective. That's my my shtick in every game. Play the objective. Go after the objective. If a Charlie.
We've lost command post back.
Oh. Hey Dooku, how you doing, man?
Yes. Down your aggression. Let us feed you.
Jeez. And let's heal up here for a second.
The Jedi Master Yoda has been spotted.
Well, that's not good. We don't like him. Defend this, yeah. Got incoming.
Count Dooku is here.
Oh, where did he come from, for fuck's sake? Well, they're all over the fucking place. Alright. Got some points on me now.
We have transports inbound. Get ready.
There we go. We got 100% pretty easily this time. Let's get ready to go to the transport. Kind of unfortunate that I spawned this. I didn't look at the percentages. Here they come. The one is right next to us. Let's board it quickly before they start guarding it. There we go. Board it! Should give us an edge on like the actual assault or something. I don't think it does. It's like waiting until all of us are boarded, which is not really true. Because even if you don't board, it just goes at some point. Maybe it's just a chance for the enemies to farm you a bit, I don't know. I'm not really sure of the purpose of this. I mean, maybe it's slightly immersive if it wasn't kind of stupid. The ship is just hovering there and soldiers are just ignoring it because they can't shoot at it, I don't know. Yeah, you see the time. Oh, maybe it's the time we get inside the ship that went longer. It started on 30, and now it's 50. I don't know. He's impressed, apparently. Does that mean we get more time inside this one? I wonder. Okay, yes, give us the cutscene.
Once on board the Republic ship, you'll find that I've identified strategic targets for your attack.
Ooh, we have enough points, but I don't really want to be these guys, so let's be, like, this guy. Let's back these big boys up, because I really don't dislike playing one of these guys. It's not what I play Battlefront. I play Battlefront to be a soldier on the line and, like, see a thousand more of us run alongside me, you know? Like, be part of the big battle. If you want to be a Jedi, you play one of the RPG-style games, not this. General Grievous is over there, yeah.
We're securing the objective.
I'm waiting for my smoke grenade. But it seems like our guys are really pushing hard. Oh shit. didn't notice Anakin to my side. There's like three heroes in there. Anakin, who was it? Anakin, Obi-Wan, and Yoda. Here's Anakin. Yeah, he's running away. Taking these alcoves is kind of important to actually controlling this point. Alright, help Dooku do that. There's Yoda still in there. Gave us a nice push. Yoda. Come on, little green boy. Guys playing Yoda is smart enough not to push. One of them saw me, I'm pretty sure.
Area secured. Proceed to the second phase.
Oh, there we go. Kill this commando. We're good. The smoke doesn't really go where you want it to go, doesn't it?
All units rejoice. Count Dooku
is here. All units rejoice. This tactical droid is hilarious, really. One of the best voices of the game. Here's the battle. Oh shit! What the fuck? They're behind us, you idiots! Wow, that's crazy. We have a lot of points, so we can just keep spawning this dude. We made it! Run, little droids, run! Of explosives is really unhealthy. Oof. That was a Wookiee's thermal detonator. That arc in the corner. Let's breach this bitch.
We're attacking the target.
Destroy the fucking generator. You see how easy it is once you actually breach into this room. This game can end in seconds, or it can, you know, be really a bottleneck that is unpassable. Anakin came behind everybody and killed all, but we killed two generators and like a third of the health of the last one. So either we win this now or we'll win this next time we'll breach. We still have 3 minutes, so, you know. There's a hero here. Why did that Anakin guy just left Yoda in there to die? That was pretty horrible. Yeah, they're not gonna let us breach now. We're not gonna get this on this attack, I think. Oh, we breached. We breached the control. Can we go see the generator? Come on, come on, push. Just kill the generator. Oh. Yeah, generator is eating shit. Yeah, we won. Nice. Good job. Killed by Obi-Wan at the end of this. Woo! Victory. Very nice. What's the button? GG. These guys score crazy. I mean, I usually get close to the top of my own team, but not enough to be in that part. Noise. Okay, cool. Yeah, we did fine, I guess. Decently. Okay. Well, guys, I think this is enough for this Star Wars celebration. Go see a Star Wars movie. Have a great Star Wars day. May the 4th be with you until its end, which, you know, supposedly it's in 35 minutes, but it's really until whenever you finish viewing your last movie of the day. So yeah, go enjoy some Star Wars fun. I'm definitely going to go watch the last episode of Clone Wars that I haven't seen yet. And have a great night, guys. Tomorrow, pretty much activity as usual. It's Tuesday. We're going to have a morning stream with Corona and then an evening stream, Minecraft War Thunder, or we'll try the new XCOM Chimera, I think. Is it? We'll see. One of those. So anyway, guys, good night. I'll see you tomorrow. Subscribe and watch the VODs on YouTube. And yeah, bye-bye.